Direct from Los Angeles, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the 2008 LA Auto Show.
Well, good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us. This has been a challenging year across the board. But despite a projected decline in the industry of about 18%, we at Kia, we fared relatively well, gaining all important market share, and for good reason. Our value story is extremely relevant today. But the fact that Kia is gaining on Toyota and Honda in several segments, well, that's the result of advances in quality, design, and engineering that have transformed Kia into a brand that can compete on the main stage. Now, some of the folks driving Kia forward are here in the audience, and I'd like to take just a minute to introduce them to all of you. First, the president of Kia Motors Corporation, Mr. E.S. Chung. President Chung?
Good morning.
Group president and CEO of Kia Motors America and Kia Motors Manufacturing Georgia, Mr. B.M. Ahn. Good morning. And our chief design officer all the way from Frankfurt, Peter Schreier. Peter? Okay, let's get on to the main event. When the Soul concept was revealed in Detroit about 3 years ago, it created quite a stir. Soul was a vehicle that simply didn't fit a single category. It mixed a lot of styles and influences in a fresh new way. No one knew exactly what segment it belonged in, but everybody knew we just had to build it. Since then, Kia designers have been exploring the possibilities. Guys like me have been teasing you with variations on the Soul theme. Today, we're dropping all the veils to show you the production model coming to Kia showrooms early next spring. And as you'll see, it's arriving with all its design, its personality, and soul intact. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2010 Kia Soul. Now, the Kia Soul is the first of a new breed. It's a brand-defining vehicle. It's a game-changer, a halo car, if you will. But it's a halo car that's actually attainable. It was designed right here in Southern California by a team that really understands the American market. Now, before we go into the Soul, let's talk about the customer it was designed for. For this passionate design, the core audience, as you might expect, is young adults. Now, if I do say so myself, when it comes to this demographic, I like to think I have a little expertise, okay? You see, for the past 20 years or so, my twins, Andrew and Meredith, have been educating me on their generation's ever-changing tastes. Tastes that are superior to my own in every respect, as they frequently share with me. That's why I've asked Andy and Meredith to say hi via webcam today. They should be logging in from school just any time now. And you know what? I can't wait to see them. It's been a few months. Young buyers are definitely the sweet spot, but we expect Soul to attract a wide variety of people as well. People who love technology, but hate to be categorized. People who love finding the next best thing, but hate being hit over the head with advertising. Soul doesn't just look different. It is different, right down to its all-new platform. It's launching with a choice of engines, a 1.6 liter or a 2.0 liter, both good for about 30 miles to the gallon. Inside the cabin is where Soul really shows off. Whether you want a personal lounge on wheels or a fuel-sipping cargo carrier, Soul's got the power to surprise. And Soul is surprisingly roomy, with seating for 5 adults. There's also plenty of space for their stuff, and that's with the seats up, or with the seats down to hold even more gear. After all, why else would a person need seats folded down anyway? Hey, guys. How you doing? Welcome to Los Angeles. Thanks, buddy. How long you been there? Huh? Andy, stay focused. All right, we're going to keep going. All right. They look great. The interior is loaded up with all kinds of cool storage. 14 zones in all for, well, I'm not really sure what. But the glove box is big enough to swallow a frozen turkey, which I guess could come in handy this time of year. You've also got a cup holder that can handle a big gulp and even more storage. What do you need all this storage for anyway? Now, for some reason, audio systems are usually hidden away. In the Sol, we take just the opposite approach. The audio system is integral to its design and includes a CD, MP3, Sirius satellite radio, USB, iPod connectivity. An LCD lighting scheme is picked up on the floating center stack. Very cool. It's all great stuff. And the best seat in the house is right behind the steering wheel. The cockpit features the LCD illumination, sport gauges, and available steering wheel mounted audio controls. You're going to see a lot of surprising options too. Things like electronic stability control, cool graphics packages, a premium 315-watt stereo system, and lots more stuff you wouldn't expect to see in this class. So, Andy and Meredith, what do you think? That's good news. If they like it, that's a great sign. Later. Andy, cut it out. You guys, equal opportunity. Go back to school. Okay, so you can always count on one thing, I guess. They're always looking for money. Now, something my kids didn't need to know is that there's more than one Sol. There's the Sol Plus, the Sol Exclaim, and the Sol Sport. So we think we have something pretty exciting here. Well, you know what? Let me rephrase that. We know we have something exciting here. Now, how do we make the most of the opportunity? Well, that's a challenge I'll be sharing with the newest member of the Kia team. He's the Vice President of Marketing at Kia Motors America. Please welcome Michael Sprague.
All right, good morning. Thanks, Tom. You know, this is just a coincidence, but I'm also the father of twins, except mine just turned one this past Monday. And sitting there and listening to Tom, I realized it is not going to get any easier. Now, in my short tenure here at Kia, I've learned that the Sol is a product that cannot be pigeonholed. The same can be said for the generation that we built it for. Businesses in every category are pursuing Gen Y, and by necessity, we're all tossing our old marketing textbooks aside. For this generation, there's got to be purpose in every connection. And you can see this in some of the examples here in our display. Instead of the traditional auto show brochure, we've created a collection of postcards. But these just aren't normal postcards. We call them soul cards. And each one explores a different aspect of the soul's personality, such as its stylishness, its sex appeal, and its sportiness. On the reverse, we included a short blurb describing the unique quality and attributes inside each Kia Soul. Now, our soul cards also feature new mobile technology. When you scan this barcode with a current generation camera phone, you get an immediate link to the Kia Soul microsite, where you can learn the latest information about the product. In fact, we have some barcodes scattered throughout the display here, so you can scan it and try it on your own. Now, Gen Y is not a generation of passive consumers. Through technology, they've become creators, programmers, and distributors of their own media universe. And on our Sol microsite, we're giving them ways to share their perceptions through texting and other forms of word of mouth. Now, it's a little too early to give away too many details, but you can expect Kia to take the power to surprise to a whole new level. We're also going to bring Sol directly to the consumers in ways that tie to their own personal passions. For example, the Vans Warped Tour, which is an indie rock concert series that connected Kia to the young music fans. This event is put on by Vans, the company that brought personalization to sneakers. And it's a perfect fit for us. Because Sol promises to do the same for our cars. And their sneakers are pretty cool too. So, the core of this personalization idea began at the very outset of the Sol project way before I joined the company. And to tell you more about it, please welcome the chief designer of Kia Design America, Mr. Tom Kearns.
Thanks, Michael, and great shoes, by the way. You know, the Soul really gave us a lot of freedom to express new ideas. And for a designer, frankly, that's what gets us out of bed every day. We envision Soul as a truly personal statement, a vehicle that a dozen different customers could or would perceive a dozen different ways. It all began with a single, simple sketch by one of our talented designers, Mike Torpy. How close did the final product come to Mike's sketch? Take a look at this video that Mike sent me.
Hi, I'm Mike Torpy, and this is the home of the Kia Soul, the Kia Design Center. Let me show you around. Come on, follow me. It's no secret that we're excited about the Kia Soul. One of the things that we're most excited about is that the production car is just as cool as the original concept. Check it out. This is the original sketch. Pretty close to the original, don't you think? Soul's cool, but what's even cooler are all the ways you can personalize it. Customers can express themselves through some killer features. Check it. Like sunroofs and body graphics. Mirrors can be body color or accent. Even different grills. Might want to change your skirt. Can't forget about the wheels. Customers can personalize the interior too. How about these seats? Sweet. The Soul logos even glow at night. So as you can see, there are all sorts of ways that you can personalize your Soul, with even more options and accessories to come. So watch out for Soul. This little guy is gonna be huge.
All right, now there's a guy who really likes his job. And he's right, you know, Soul is going to mean big things for Kia. Mike and the entire Kia design team did a great job designing the car. In the grand scheme of things, Kia is a young brand, and that really represents a great opportunity for all of us on the design team. What makes us different is we don't have the long burden of design history. Instead, we have the ultimate challenge and the ultimate freedom to create something completely new. Let me tell you, that's a fantastic feeling. You might even say it's uplifting. We want our customers to share that in that sensation, with the freedom to make their own Soul a personal statement. So we've created a lot of cool accessories for them to personalize their car, more than any other vehicle before, and many of which are on display here today. I, for one, can't wait to see how buyers will make every Soul one of a kind.
Well, as you've seen, we are definitely pumped up about Soul. Now, guys like Tom and Michael, they get to put their mark on every aspect of a car's design. Guys like me, we get to put it on the window. Now, we can't share the final MSRP just yet, but I can tell you this. In fact, I can assure you, the Kia Soul will be very aggressively priced, comfortably in the teens. And that includes all four, include from the basic Soul all the way up to the Soul Sport. I gotta tell you, Kia Soul is truly huge news for Kia.
You could also call it expansive.
Well, how about this one? It's big. It's really big for Kia.
It's sure to boost sales.
That I agree with. And folks, you know what? He's not blowing any hot air. So thanks for joining us tonight, or this afternoon. We're available to answer any questions that you have. Thanks.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more press pass coverage of the LA Auto Show and all other major auto shows, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.